So once we have retrieved the unique sequences, we are ready to align the sequences to the reference template alignment. In this tutorial, you will learn what the SILVA reference template alignment contains, what are the alignment steps, how you can improve and speed up the alignment, and what the alignment file looks like. So the whole point of this process is to identify the sequences, and for that we align them to this reference template. In Chipster we use the SILVA reference template, but you can also give your own. The current full SILVA template, which is the version 138.1, contains about 146,000 sequences. The alignment is 50,000 columns long, so it is very long, and you need to remember that you only PCR'd up a very small part of the typically the 16S ribosomal RNA gene. So in order to make the alignment process faster, you can target the alignment process to that region of the SILVA template which matches the area that you amplified. So in order to target it, you need the coordinates of that region in the SILVA template. And if you don't know the coordinates, you can easily get them by doing a small alignment with a small number of samples, so that it runs fast against the whole template, and then you will get the coordinates you can use in a second run. If you want to read more about the SILVA reference files, here is a link to the Motor Wiki. Let's look at the actual alignment process. So in Chipster you have a tool called Align Sequences to Reference, which is based on the Motor Align Seq and PCR Seq commands. As input, you need to give the unique sequences and the matching count table. The actual alignment happens in three steps. So first the tool needs to find what is the closest template sequence to the query sequence. And for that, it uses k-mer search with 8 mers. So it basically cuts both the template sequences and the query sequences to this 8 base long pieces and tries to figure out between what sequences the 8 mer content is most similar. Once it has figured out which one is the closest template sequence, it will take that and the query sequence and do a Needleman-Wunsch pairwise alignment. In order to do that with the template sequence, it needs to decap the template sequence first, because remember, it comes from the alignment, so it contains gaps. Once this pairwise alignment has been done, it will eventually reinsert the gaps using the NAST algorithm, so that the query sequence alignment is now compatible with the original big template alignment. The speed of this process depends on the number and the length of the query and template sequences. So the length of the template sequences you can affect by limiting the alignment to the template region which corresponds to the part which you amplified. And if you limit the alignment this way, you also get better alignment quality and you save space. Let's look at the result files. So the alignment is given in FASTA format. So you see an example here. So it's the usual FASTA, so the name of the sequence, and then the actual sequence. Now, because it's an alignment, there are gaps, so there are dashes, and there are also periods before the first base in the sequence, and there would be also periods after the last base of the sequence. You also get now two summary files, so one for your aligned sequences and one for the reference. So the new thing here now is that now you have this start and end positions. So this now refers to the start and end position in the alignment. And for example here, as you can see, most of them start at the position 8, but there is at least one sequence which the starting position of which starts much later, so this is suspicious. From the reference summary, you can see information about the reference sequences in that area. In my case, I have limited the search to a small part of the SILVA template, so hence my numbers here are quite small. Again, here as well, you can see that there is a strange starting position here. The other thing that you might be interested in is what is the maximum homopolymer length in the reference, because later on you will screen the alignment and you will want to get rid of sequences which have longer homopolymer lengths than this one.